In this numerical, when the earth contracts to 1/64 of its volume, what will be the new day duration? Right? Let us solve this question. In this question, it's given that the earth contracts, right? So we will take the data as given into the numerical, that what is before the contraction and what are the data and details of earth after the contraction, right? So just writing it over here. So here T1, omega 1 and R1 are the values of the earth before contraction, and T2, omega 2 and R2 are the values of earth after contraction. That is, T1 is the period of revolution, omega is the angular velocity of the earth, and R1 and R2 are the radius of the earth before and after contraction, right? By the law of conservation of angular momentum, we know that the product of I and omega is always constant, where I is the moment of inertia of that particular body and omega is the angular velocity of that body, right? So here I is the moment of inertia of earth, as is given as 2/5 mr square, where m is the mass, and we have already shown above that mass is constant before and after contraction, right? So I omega will be coming as 2/5 mr square into omega 1, and after the contraction it will be coming as I2 omega 2, which is 2/5 mr² into omega 2, right? So I'm just putting up the values over here. Just follow the question. So this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2, right? So just put up the value of I as 2/5 mr² for I1 and 2/5 mr² for I2. That is moment of inertia of the earth with R1 and R2 as before and after contraction, the value of the radius. 2/5 m is cancelled into the RHS and LHS, that is being a common. So we get r1 square omega 1 equal to r2 square omega 2, and we know that omega is equal to 2π/T, or 2 pi into f. So, using the formula omega equal to 2 pi by t, we will replace the value of omega 1 and omega 2 into this equation. So, we get, after cancelling 2 pi from both the LHS and RHS, we get the relation of R2, R1 and T1, T2 as shown above. So T2 is R2 by R1 whole square into T1, and we know that T1, that is a duration of Earth before contraction for the whole day, is 24 hours, right? So we will put the value of T1 as 24 hours over here to get the relation as shown above. Into the question, it's also given that volume after contraction will be equal to 1 by 64 times volume of the earth before contraction. Earth is also a sphere, so volume of a sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. We know it. This is a simple formula from mensuration. So putting up the value of volume as 4 by 3 pi r cube after contraction, that is r equal to r2, and volume before contraction with 4 by 3 pi r cube with r equal to r1, right? So we get the relation as shown over here. 64 can also be written as 4 cube. So R2 by R1 whole cube is equal to 1 by 4 cube. So taking the cubic root in both sides of the equation, that is in LHS and RHS, we get R2 by R1 is equal to 1 by 4, which is the relation which we are willing to derive. So we have already derived in equation number 3 earlier that the relation between T2 and T1, that is T2 equal to R2 by R1 whole square into T1. But now we have derived that R2 by R1 is 1 by 4. So putting up this value over here in the relation of T2 and T1, we get the value of T2 as 3 by 2. Just cut the number 24 by 16. We get the value 3 by 2, which is 1.5 hour. So 1.5 hour is the duration of day after contraction on Earth. The same duration earlier before contraction was 24 hour, which I have already taken into the question. So our answer is T2 equal to 1.5 hour.